In this video, I will show you the different data types in JavaScript. What are data types? In computer science, or in programming, a data type is an attribute of data which tells the compiler or interpreter how the programmer intends to use the data. What does that mean? Well, it's kind of like telling the computer, "Hey computer, this is a number, and from now on, I want to calculate with it." So data types is something that we know in JavaScript. Different data types exist and we interact with them. But unlike certain other programming languages, when you're creating a variable and assigning a value to that variable, you don't have to explicitly say, "Hey, compiler, who's interpreting my JavaScript, this, by the way, is a number, I'm gonna calculate with it." Okay, so the simple fact of us writing or storing a number in the variable is enough to already make clear what type of data type that we're dealing with. All data types. Let's start out with the five most common data types. You can see in here on screen, these are strings, so our written text, like we see Jane written. You can write it with either single or with double quotation marks. I don't even know which I prefer. It really depends on which comes more naturally when I'm writing, when I'm coding. Then numbers, we can have integers, so like 35, or decimals, 35.5. And note that you do not need quotation marks for that, okay? That is very important. That distinguishes numbers from strings. There's gonna be a quiz at the end of the video about that. Then isEmployee shows us the type of Boolean. So Boolean means it's either true or false. And again, no, we don't write a Boolean with quotation marks. Skills, that is an array. Array you can think of as a list type. So what we're doing here is in our skills, we have a list of skills we have, and they're written within these square brackets, so that always is for you a visual hint, this must be an array. And within that you can store, as we see here, strings, but you could also store numbers, booleans, and so on. And note, negotiation, closing deals. What is that for a data type within our array? If you know, write it in the comment section below. And then the last variable we see is contract, and that contains an object. An object can have multiple properties, so start date, job title, line manager, these are all properties and they're written with keys and values, okay? Start date is the key and the value is 2020-11. Our next data type is undefined. We see here we're declaring the variable of let team, so we're creating with the keyword let our variable team. If you want to know more about how to declare variables, how they work in general, have a look at the video I'm linking on the top right about now. Okay, so we have our team, but we haven't assigned a value. In such a situation, we have a data type of undefined. And as soon as we assign a value, in this case, Miami Heat, the data type will change to string. And the third line of code we see here is that we're assigning null to foo. So in that case, we're deliberately not assigning an object, so we're assigning null to food. And please be aware, if we would have quotation marks around null, then we would be assigning the string of null to food, okay? So when you want to assign null to a variable, make sure to not add quotation marks. Big int is the second last data type that we're gonna have a look at. This you use so that you can safely store and operate on large integers. That is because with the data type of numbers at a certain point, it doesn't work well with very, very large numbers. Then the last data type is symbol. Here I came up with an example just to show you how this works. So we have our name one and our name two, and we each apply a symbol and pass the value of Jane into it. So we're creating two separate symbols. And now if we were to compare them for us humans, Jane and Jane looks like exactly the same thing. But since these are data types of symbols, they're not. So symbols are always unique. Now, very important, the last four data types that we looked at, undefined, null, bigint, and symbol. These are somewhat advanced JavaScript data types, so it's most likely that if you're starting out learning JavaScript, you probably won't use them in the beginning, but just to keep the topic of data type complete, I chose to cover them and to show them. Type of. You can use typeof, as you see here in this example, to find out what data type the value is that you have stored in any given variable. So let's just take the very first example. We see that if we call typeof on the variable name, then we will get back the value of string. So it's telling us, hey, in the variable of name, you have a data type of string saved. So I suggest you go and try that out with some variables that you create. Now, if you paid attention at the beginning of the video, I said that in JavaScript, we don't have to say, okay, so now I'm gonna store a value in the variable of name, and that's gonna be of a string. Because JavaScript takes care of that, it understands that if I write Jane within quotation marks, then obviously that's a string. So why should you, as someone starting out with JavaScript, even care about data types? Well, here's the thing. If you know, for example, that you have a string stored in the variable of name, that obviously means for you that you should not be using any methods to calculate with a string, because you can't calculate with a string, but you could maybe add new characters to the string, or maybe cut the string at a certain point if you needed to. So if you know what type of data is in a variable, you know how to interact. Now, I just mentioned something which we haven't discussed yet, methods. Methods are a way to manipulate objects, manipulate values in variables. This is something that I will definitely be covering in an upcoming video because it's crucial when learning JavaScript. Now onto the quiz question, and it aligns beautifully with understanding how we can work with variables. What do you think if you have a look at this screen? H1 and H2. If we compare the values of these two variables, will we get back an answer of false or true? So are the values stored in H1 and H2 one and the same thing? If yes, then we will get back true. If not, we will get back false. Now I want you to answer that question below. Write in false or true, depending on what you think we would get back. In a previous video, I asked you if you wanted to see the difference between let and var. And well, you decided because you left enough comments for me to go ahead and make such a video. So that's the next video that's gonna come up in 2 weeks' time. If you've liked the content of this video, then give us a like, and please also subscribe to this YouTube channel so that you don't miss out on any of our upcoming JavaScript beginners videos.